There's no such thing as time management. You can't manage time. You can, however, manage the things you do to become more efficient. In this video, you'll learn how to use the calendar in Outlook 2013 effectively to schedule appointments, navigate between different dates, and categorize activities. You'll also learn how to configure Outlook to see exactly what you want to see, including holidays, time zones, and weather.
Here I have an email from a colleague asking if I can conduct a customer workshop on the 2nd, 3rd, 16th, or 17th of July. In Outlook 2013, Microsoft has introduced the sneak peek view so that you can see parts of your calendar without leaving your mailbox. To see what I have booked those dates, I can simply hover over the calendar to get a peek of it. Here I see today's appointments, and I can easily navigate to other dates by marking the dates in the calendar.
Hi, I'm so sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to let you know that if you're annoyed by the ads in this video, you can access our tutorials ad-free by getting a subscription to businessproductivity.com or signing up for one of our many courses on platforms such as Udemy, CyberU, and Vimeo On Demand. I also wanted to take this opportunity to tell you a bit more about Storyals. Storyals, which stands for Story-Based Tutorials, is our video package offering for organizations that want to increase employee productivity using Office 365. With Storyals, organizations can inspire, motivate, and educate users on effective use of Office 365 by showcasing real-life best practices. Finally, I want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channels, Business Productivity and Storyals. Here you will also find my video blog, Succeed in the Digital Workplace, as well as other videos that can help you increase your productivity. If you have any questions or comments, please post them here and I'll do my very best to get back to you. With that, let's go back to the tutorial. Thank you for watching.
To go to the calendar, click Calendar or press the keyboard shortcut Ctrl 2. A new blue line has been introduced in the calendar in Outlook 2013 so that you can instantly see what you have scheduled right now. You can modify the calendar view in Outlook to show as many days as you want: a single day, work week, week, or month. Outlook marks working hours with white and outside working hours with a gray color. I prefer to see my calendar in the work week view. Outlook remembers your preferred settings, so every time you open up your calendar, the view is the same. To change the working days and working hours, click File, Options, and then Calendar. Here, I'll change my working day to start at 9 a.m. instead of the default, which is 8 a.m. By default, Outlook adds reminders to appointments 15 minutes prior to the meeting. Personally, I like to uncheck this and add reminders manually to appointments if I need them. You can add holidays for various countries to your calendar. I already have holidays for the United States added, but I'll also add holidays for the United Arab Emirates. The holidays are added to my calendar, so I'll just click OK. On Wednesday, I'm traveling to London, so in order to keep track of the time both in London and Dubai, I'll add an additional time zone to my calendar view. First, I'll put a label on my current one, DUB, and then I'll choose to show a second time zone. I'll label this one LON for London, and I'll select the time zone, and then I'll click OK. And as you can see, I now have two time zones side by side in my calendar. This really helps when I need to schedule meetings across time zones. In addition to helping out with the time zones, the new Outlook helps you prepare for the weather. The weather indicator shows the forecasted weather for the next 3 days. You can add up to 5 locations. To add a new location, click the Current Location drop-down and select Add Location. Then type in the name of the city. I'll type London and select London, UK. The weather indicators are updated to show the weather in London. By hovering over the weather indicators, you get more detailed information. You can also click More Online to open up a weather web page. Here, I can see an extended forecast so that I can prepare better for my planned trip. To change between Celsius and Fahrenheit in Outlook, click File, Options, Calendar, and scroll down to the very bottom. Select your preference and click OK to apply the settings. Now I want to mark my calendar for the requested customer workshop. To go to a specific date, you can either click the date in the calendar navigation bar, or you can right-click anywhere and select Go to Date, or press the keyboard shortcut Ctrl-G. Here, I'll write the date I want to go to, July 2nd, and my calendar is open showing the first week of July. Now I'd like to see all the proposed four dates at once to see which would be the most appropriate. To see multiple spread out dates at once, click the Day View and then click the first date you want to see. Hold down the Control key and then click the additional dates. I'll click the 3rd, 16th, and 17th. Now I can see all the dates side by side. According to my schedule, the 17th is the most appropriate, so I'll select that for the workshop. To create an appointment, click New Appointment in the menu bar or press the keyboard shortcut Ctrl-N. Another option is to mark your calendar where you want the appointment, right-click and select New Appointment. I'll give the appointment a name, Potential Customer Workshop. Since the workshop hasn't been confirmed with a customer yet, I'll change the Show As label from Busy to Tentative. This is a good reminder for myself that it hasn't yet been confirmed. In addition, my colleagues who might want to schedule meetings with me will see that this day is tentatively booked. To go back to today in my calendar, I'll just click Today in the menu bar and then click Work Week to go back to my normal view. In addition to using the Show As labeling, I often add categories to certain appointments. The categories are only visible to myself, and they help me get a better overview of how I spend my time. Here, for instance, I have a green category, which is Family, which I mark family-related appointments with. I also have a purple category for Exercise. To add a category to an appointment, mark the appointment and right-click. Select Categorize and then click All Categories. Categories work across Outlook, so here I have categories that I use for managing email. You can use categories for email, calendar appointments, contacts, and tasks. To create a new category, click New and then give the category a name. I'll name this Customer and I'll keep the default yellow color. Now the appointment has been marked with the Customer category. To quickly mark multiple appointments, you can hold down the Control key and then mark multiple appointments. Right-click and then select your category. Now I get a better overview of how much time I'm actually spending with customers each week. If you don't like the default blue color used for appointments in Outlook, you can change it. Right-click an empty area and select Color. Here you can select among a number of different colors. These colors don't hold any meaning, it's just a way to personalize your calendar based on color preference. Every morning at 8:30, I drop our kids off at nursery. And every Monday, I write our Get Sharp blog article that I post on our website. If you have an appointment that occurs multiple times in a certain pattern, you can add recurrence to the appointment so that you don't have to add it more than once. To add recurrence to an appointment, mark the appointment and click the Recurrence button. In the Recurrence Pattern section, mark when and how often the appointment is to occur. In the Range of Recurrence section, select how long you want it to recur. Here, I'll leave the default, which is no end date. Now the appointment has been added to my calendar on a weekly basis every Monday. Since I'm on a holiday the third week of July, I need to reschedule writing my blog to the Friday before. When you click on a recurring meeting, you can select to modify the entire series or just a single appointment. In this case, I just want to change a single appointment, so I'll click just this one, and then I'll change the date to the previous Friday. I'll save this appointment and I'll confirm again that I only want to change this occurrence. Now the appointment has been rescheduled to the week before. To manage my time, I use both appointments in my calendar as well as tasks for things I need to remember to follow up on. You can quickly see your upcoming tasks through the sneak peek view by hovering over Tasks. You can also see your daily tasks in the calendar view by clicking View, Daily Task List, and normal. Now I can see the task scheduled under my daily schedule. Here I can see that I need to call and reserve a venue for our planned customer roundtable event. I'm not quite sure what date we decided on for the roundtable, so I'll just search for it in my calendar. To search your calendar, click the search box. When you do, the search toolbar appears. Here you have numerous options for finding appointments. I'll just type roundtable, and I can quickly find the appointment, which is scheduled for July 6th. Perfect. By using the calendar effectively in Outlook, it will be much easier for you to manage everything you need to do during your very valuable time.